Spartan, are you here for a stadium tour? Just having to wander around, or?
I just walk here firstly.
Okay, cool.
It's okay?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Thank you, man.
You turn right in the corner here, you've got like the shop, and then there's the board as well. So
good.
You can see like all the famous players. Pete's always good stand. If you go straight down and around the back of the stadium, you've got the tours of museum.
Oh. Okay.
Thank you. Okay, tickets please. Lovely, okay. Just wait over there.
Thank you.
Famous Chelsea Football Club. My name is Peter, and I'm going to be your tour guide today. There'll also be my colleague Fiona joining us fairly shortly. Okay, the tour itself, oh, she's here now. The tour itself will be just under an hour. We start by going into the stadium there. We then make our way towards the press area where the newspaper reporters go. We then go to both dressing rooms, Chelsea's dressing room and the visitors' dressing room. We then line up in the tunnel, like the players do on a match day. And we do have a sound recording, and we also video you as you go through the tunnel. So you'll see yourselves on the big screen almost immediately after when we get to the dugouts. Okay, we then spend a bit of time there. We then make our way to the other end of the stadium. And that's where we finish the tour. If you have cameras, you can take pictures wherever we go. We ask you not to eat, drink, or smoke, or vape as you go round. Water's fine, of course. So, and if you need the restroom, then that is available in the newspaper reporter's room. Okay? One very important thing is we do ask you not to go on the pitch. Don't go on the grass, that is a red card. Okay, we have a game coming up against Dirty Leeds next week, and of course on Sunday we have a cup final against Liverpool at Wembley. So is anybody going to the game on Sunday? Oh right, okay, I might see you there. So fingers crossed, Liverpool got a few injuries, so that's good. We'll see how it goes. Okay, what we're going to do is, if you'd like to follow me, we'll make our way into the... Okay, if you'd like to come and sit along here for me. Just go to the end there, sir. Do you think Chelsea will win on Sunday?
Yeah, of course.
And yes, of course.
Yeah, I love my dog.
Mohammed's 100 links.
I know. He'll be playing. He's fit again, yeah. Yeah, just come along here. Yeah, that's it. I still wear my shirt, the one you've got on.
Yeah.
Wearing
it for the game Sunday.
Good man.
Yeah, that's cool.
Guys, if you want to sit down you can, or you can stand, it's entirely up to you. We've got safe standing, so you'll be all right. My colleague Fiona has just joined us. She's at the back. She'll make sure that you're safe. Well, you don't go where you shouldn't go. She'll look after you, make sure you're safe and okay as we go round. Okay, well, obviously I know we've got a few Chelsea fans here, but can you put your hands up if you are a Chelsea supporter, just so I get an idea? Okay, not bad. Not good, but not bad. Okay, so if you support another team, hands up, okay. So, all right, you put your hand up quickly. Who's your team? Manchester City. Where's a surprise? I tell you what, we've had more Manchester City fans here this last couple of seasons than we've had for the last 20 years. But is it because they're doing well? All right, glory hunter. You want to suffer like us Chelsea fans have suffered. Who's your team? Arsenal? Blimey, hold on it. Security.
No more life.
Why Arsenal?
That's life.
Yeah. Well, that's one answer, I suppose. Yeah, okay. How about you, sir? Do you have another team?
No, I'm from Poland. As a kid, I always play in the Pro Evolution Soccer or FIFA. I always choose.
Right.
I always support this situation. Is my
dream, no? Well, you're very welcome. Okay, so this is that young lady had her hand up. Who's your team?
City.
City, here we go. Do you want to move and sit with him?
Yeah.
any particular reason?
No, just day one
we've
always been.
Day one?
Yeah.
When was that? Last week?
Yeah, I was born last week, yeah.
Yeah. They're very complimentary. Okay, so anyone else have their hands up over here? Do you have your hand up?
Yes, I was.
Who?
Liverpool.
You're not going Sunday though, are you? Yeah. Are you going to Wembley Sunday?
No.
Ah, good. Well, bad luck anyway. I'll be gentle with you. But it's nice to see a few Chelsea fans here anyway, because Chelsea's my club. This is the only stadium we've ever played football at. We were formed on the 10th of March 1905, and this has always been our home stadium. Our current capacity is just under 40,000 people, and we are looking to, in the next 5 to 10 years, to build a new stadium, either here or somewhere else in London, that will house 60,000 people, like Arsenal's stadium, like Tottenham. Like Tottenham Stadium. So we'll have that big stadium here or somewhere else in London, because so many people want to come and see Chelsea. And I mean, don't forget, we're 10th at the moment. Look, we're in the final of the Carabao Cup. When we beat dirty Leeds, then we... So we won't fall out. When we play Leeds, then obviously one of us will go through to the next round, the FA Cup. So we've still got a couple of trophies worth playing for. And Leeds are more concerned with getting promotion anyway. So it should be a good game. Having said that, who knows what will happen here. For Chelsea, it's what they call a period of transition. We've got lots of new players, we've got a new coach. You don't need to take my picture, okay? If you want a picture with Fiona, there is a little extra cost, okay? Very generous. But you negotiate that with her. But you can all have your picture taken there anyway. If you need to use the restroom in there, then that's your option. A press conference that Carlo Ancelotti gave when he was here as manager. We often have sort of between 60 and 80 press reporters here to report on Chelsea, but when we play Champions League football, we've on occasions had over 200 people in here, so it gets very, very crowded. At the back of the room, we serve hot and cold food, and over here, we have a free bar. Hooray! Unfortunately, there is no alcohol. We used to serve alcohol here, but the newspaper reporters didn't want to go home. Can you believe it? They'd stay on drinking and drinking and drinking. So in the end, we had to make it so there's only soft drinks here, tea and coffee, that type of thing, and water. You'll notice those two shelves we've got up there. On a match day, we normally put a few little trophies that we've got here. We actually got those shelves from Tottenham's trophy room. They said, well, we don't need them, we won't be winning anything. So we said, well, okay, they offered them to us, so we thought, well, Johnny will take them. Taken. So if you are ready, please make sure you've got all your bags, coats, scarves, whatever you need, and follow me this way, please. There we are, the space up.
Oh, thank you.
Okay. I want you to get lost. Make it at Real Madrid, suffering with injuries a lot, but I'm glad we've seen the back of Karim Benzema because he always scored against Chelsea. But of course we've got two Barcelona greats there, Ronaldinho and Messi, and Maldini played in the first Champions League match that we had back in 1998. Along there we've got players of yesteryear, and they played in friendlies or testimonials here at Stamford Bridge. Sadly, none of them are still alive today. And along this back wall, we've got players from the English League, Premiership as well. Number six is the only one without a name on it. Who knows whose shirt that belongs to or would belong to? Anybody? You should know, madam.
No.
Well, all right, I'll give you... L titles. Although we did lose to Manchester City the other day, I'm sorry. we might have lost the battle, but we haven't lost the war. So we've got them again fairly soon. But anyway, we've got some England players over here. Millie Bright, who's injured. Come down here, sir. Doesn't really matter what side you want, it's only a bit of fun. Okay, so we need to make two teams. If we could have the good looking ones on one side, please. Oh, never mind. Okay, so this is what it'd be like when we play Leeds, of course, or any team we play here. The camera is just up there. It looks like a Star Wars helmet, so you can wave, you can do that, you can do that, whatever you want to do. Don't do anything unpleasant because we'll know who you are. When you get out there, if you turn left, you'll then see the big screen and you'll see yourselves on it. And because it's all heat generated, then it disappears after about sort of 20 seconds or so. It's just a bit of fun, really. So if you want to take a picture of yourself, by all means do so. You'll go past this door on the right, which is where we're at the beginning of the entrance to where the referee and his assistants get changed. And the first door on the left there is for the drug testing. So players are randomly drug tested after a game, and hopefully we'll keep the game clean. So just bear me a second, I'll just activate the music. This is a track called The Liquidator. There was a big hit in the 60s. I love the words, but this is the tune that Chelsea go out to. Some of you may be familiar with it. So, okay, here we go, teams. Down so that one can come out and see the The pitch itself is 95% real grass, which means it's 5% artificial. We import our grass from Holland, called perennial rye grass, and apparently Holland is the best grass. Look how it drops down from the centre circle to the side by about 4 or 5 inches. That's to allow for natural growth. Now we recycle all our water from the pitch itself, and then we just regenerate it and use it elsewhere. As we swing round from where we started, you can see the gull nets are at the top. That's because we're doing it. Chelsea FC. Below that is where the directors and owners sit with their guests, and of course people, officials from the other side on a match day. We've got 17 of those bar fronted boxes, the biggest ones of which will hold 24 people. And if you want to buy one, it's £2 million. The only problem is, if you can afford that, you have to buy them for 10 years. So, it's not very very cost effective. As we swing round, you'll see a glass mounted part of the stand there. That's where the wives and girlfriends go on a match day. That's when players run over there and start blowing kisses and what have you. You now know why they are doing it in that area. And that is the Paul Cannaville suite, or the Cannaville suite. And Paul does hospitality on match days. Okay, this way, please. please.
Amazing weather. It started to rain again.
Sorry?
Start to rain again.
Oh, I know. It's coming from the west.
Amazing, amazing.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
That's all right.
Thank you so much. I said to me, no. Thank you.
Thank you.